Okay, welcome to the presentation. Today we're going to be covering NinjaTrader 8. I'm from DayTradeToWin, and this is a presentation that will show you how to download NinjaTrader, how to install it, how to use the charts, how to use the dome, all the important features you'd want to know, whether you're coming from NinjaTrader 7 or if you're brand new to NinjaTrader. Now, this is a very basic plain chart. If you're going to be trading, you're going to look at this chart and probably not know what you're doing. You'd be guessing, you'd be placing orders randomly. You might need some guidance. And that's what indicators strive to do. Indicators will indicate to you what you should do. They can be in the form of indicating levels of support or resistance, which means where the market is expected to react. Maybe it won't go past a certain level of resistance. Or if you have support, the market might continue in that direction. There are indicators for all of these things. And you can take a look at some of the indicators included with NinjaTrader by going to the indicators menu right here on the top of the chart. It's this little button right here. I prefer to right-click the chart and then go to indicators. This is a big list of all the indicators that are included. There are a couple that we at DayTradeToWin recommend applying right away. That is the ATR indicator. By the way, these are alphabetically listed, so they're easy to find. So double-click on ATR. This will add the ATR indicator. What is the ATR? It's the average true range. So this will measure the price of the last, let's say, 14 bars by default and plot a value. So using this tool, you can gauge how volatile the market is. Typically, we'll use an ATR period value of 4. So I'm changing this to 4. And then clicking apply. So once I click apply, you can see the ATR appears on the bottom of the chart. It's this green, bluish, squiggly line. We'll get back to that in a minute. So the other indicator in this big list of indicators is the bar timer. We recommend the bar timer because it gives us an indication of how much time is left until the current plotting candle closes. So with it enabled here, we'll show you exactly what it does. There's really nothing you have to change for this indicator. All these settings are good as they are. So I'm pretty satisfied with this configuration. I'm going to save these settings by clicking the OK button. All right. So, by the way, if I had purchased an indicator from DayTradeToWin, for example, I would, after installing it, I would find it here. We're going to actually go through the process of installing an indicator in just a moment, but know that purchased indicators will appear in this list after you import them. Okay. So we've got the ATR here at the bottom. This green value right here is the ATR value presently. So the market is always plotting a candle on the right-hand side of the chart if the market is open. On a 5-minute chart, it will take 5 minutes for a candle to complete its plotting. So each of these bars represents 5 minutes in time. This chart currently isn't showing this. Let me just double check on my data feed here, make sure that it's connected. Yes, it's probably just a temporary market thing. There would normally be a countdown in the bottom right-hand corner here, indicating how much time we have left in the market. So if it's counting down from 5 minutes, we obviously have 5 minutes left. If you see one there, you've got maybe 1 minute left. So it's a good way to time yourself if your strategy depends on placing a trade at a certain time. But for now, the market's closed, so the bar timer is not showing me anything live right now. And that's why you're not seeing price move around. Thank you, everyone, for attending. And if you have any more questions, let us know.